Hey, hi. Get dummies is a powerful technique of converting your categorical variables into numeric variables. Although it has a lot of advantages associated with it, but there's one drawback that it introduces. It introduces multicollinearity. In this video, I'll show you how multicollinearity is introduced in get dummies and how you can overcome them. So stay tuned.
Let's start by importing the necessary Python modules. I store my data into a data frame called df. Let's see what the data frame contains. It contains a total of 8 rows and 4 columns. My dependent column is income, and I have 3 independent columns, age, sex, and overtime, 2 of which are categorical in nature. As we know, sklearn does not accept categorical variables but accepts numeric variables while building models, so we'll have to convert the 2 categorical columns into numeric. I store the income variable in target underscore col variable. I also store the 2 categorical variables in a cat vars list variable. I create a simple function called plot underscore correlation, which will produce a heat map of correlations. The function first finds the top 10 correlated features with respect to the target variable and then finds correlation between the features themselves. A very useful visualization which will bring out the multicollinearity between the features that we have in hand. Next, I create a function encode underscore cat underscore var underscore fit underscore model. The function accepts the data frame along with the categorical variables, target variables, options to either drop one column after get dummies, and also whether to plot or not to plot the correlation heat map. Let's create an instance of the linear regression module. Let's look at the first case where I take the categories and use pd.get underscore dummies to generate numeric variables from categories and fit a simple linear regression model. If you look at the coefficients carefully, overtime underscore n and overtime underscore y have the same coefficient value but with a different sign, signifying multicollinearity. If we observe the graph as well, the last row of the graph and the second column, which signifies the correlation between overtime underscore y and overtime underscore n, has a value of -1. Signifying that they are heavily correlated in the negative direction. The basic assumption of linear regression fails if you have multicollinearity in your data. To avoid such cases, sklearn gives you an option in pd.get underscore dummies called drop first. By setting it to true, you can drop one of the columns generated using get dummies. If I make use of this option, 2 columns have disappeared and just 2 columns remain, and there is no multicollinearity in the data, which is also visible from the graph. Is that the only way we can remove multicollinearity in categorical data? No. We have lasso regression to our rescue. Even if I don't drop the first column using pd.getDummies, lasso regression would automatically do feature selection for me, provided I have used the right value of alpha and create a generalized regression model. Now, although I have all the columns in place and multicollinearity is being displayed in the heat map, but the value of coefficients, if you notice, are set to 0. Thus, there is no effect of multicollinearity in the data as the weights of those features have been equated to 0. If you do have any questions with what we covered in the video today, then feel free to ask in the comment section below and I'll do my best to answer those. If you enjoy these tutorials and would like to support them, then the easiest way is to simply like the video and give it a thumbs up. And also, it's a huge help to share these videos with anyone who you think would find them useful. Be sure to subscribe for future videos, and thank you all for watching.